So I've only been working in the NHS for the last sort of 3 years or so, but I've definitely seen that the NHS has been massively underfunded. In the last year or so, I've seen a lack of funding for really essential services, and having to say to patients that, you know, we used to be able to offer a service like, for example, asthma nurses seeing patients with asthma while they're in hospital, but we can no longer offer that service because they're too overwhelmed with the amount that they're seeing as outpatients, with shortage of beds and trying to get people discharged as quickly as possible. That's a constant pressure that the whole team sort of works with, which I think is really hard. And a lot of that comes down to staffing, but also resources and sort of management of resources as well. Patients that have quite complicated discharge plans who need quite a lot of specialist care in place before they can go home, and that can often take a really long time to source, and those patients can then end up waiting in hospital for a long time, which can lead to them getting unwell again and then sort of delay how long it takes them to go home. And similarly with patients who don't have as complex needs but maybe need to go to a nursing home or have some sort of care at home. Patients can remain in hospital for months, even waiting for a nursing home bed. There's just a big, generally in the NHS, I think there's just a big morale sort of slump. A lot of people feel really demoralized, and especially coming out of COVID, a lot of people that I talk to feel like they really put, you know, their heart and soul into working through COVID and didn't really get any sort of reward or gratification out of it, and there wasn't really any thanks. What I would ask of the incoming government, whoever they might be, would obviously be more staff and more sort of funding for the NHS in general. I think working in a hospital, there's also a real lack of infrastructure in terms of support for staff. I also think that just people need to feel a bit more valued, and I think that comes in different ways, whether that's in terms of pay or in terms of other sort of benefits that people get as a workplace, or annual leave, or you know, the rest of it. And actually trying to ways that financially de-incentivize services from people working overtime. Yeah, I don't think people really have hope that the new government's going to change anything. I'd be happy to be proved wrong though, but I guess we'll have to wait and see.